I am Sachin Prabhu. I study in grade 6 Division D. Do you all know there is a rare, legendary and mythological plant of India called as Brahmakamal? It is also is commonly known as Night Blooming Cerus, Queen of the Night, Lady of the Night, as is the beautiful lotus-like blooms late night. Brahmakamal blooms only for one night in an entire year. It blooms between the July and September after sunset from 7 PM onwards and takes about 2 hours to full bloom. About 8 inches in diameter and remains open throughout the night. Let me share you more information with you all about this plant. Brahmakamal is named after the Brahma, the god of creation. Popularly known as the orchid cactus, as the flower has orchid-like beauty and plant resembles cactus in habitat. In India, it is treated as a sacred plant recognized as the flower of Lord Brahma. It is believed to bring the lotus of good luck and prosperity, and a home where the flowers bloom is very auspicious and lucky. Brahmakamal is a medicinal herb. The plant is considered an herb in the Tibetan medicine. It has a bitter taste and is also used to cure urogenital disorders. They have a large, pure, white, star-like flowers with lovely fragrance to help their pollinators to locate the blooms by the moon or the star light. The Brahmakamal plant is a state flower of Uttarakhand and found in Himalayas, where the people have been offering them with devotion in the hill temples at Kedarnath and Badrinath. Thank you.
Hello everyone. I am Joshua from grade 6 C. We are all familiar with a health-related condition called diabetes. Did you know that there's a herbal remedy for diabetes known as insulin plant? The consumption of this leaves is believed to lower blood glucose levels. Let me share more information about this plant. Costus ingenuus, common name, fiery costus or spangled flag, is a species of herbaceous plants in the family of Costaceae, native to eastern Brazil. In India, it is also known as insulin plant. Insulin plant is a perennial upright spreading plant growing to a height of 2 feet. The leaves are large and fleshy with a parallel venation and are spirally arranged around the stems. The stems of this plant have a light purple shade and the flowers of this plant are orange in color. The leaves of this plant have an active constituent called cosolic acid, which is found to be beneficial in controlling diabetes. When this is ingested by a human, it makes the pancreatic cells to release insulin, thus curing high blood glucose levels in the body. Thank you.
Hello everybody, my name is Ms. Arohi Deshpandar and today I am going to tell you more about oranges. You all commonly know this plant by the name of orange plant, but its scientific name is Citrus excelensis or Citrus excelensis. Oranges are believed to be the natives of tropical regions of Asia, especially the Malay Archipelago. In India, oranges are commonly found in Nagpur, which is also called the orange city. They belong to the family of Rutaceae. Orange plant is an important agricultural product used for both the juicy fruit pulp and their aromatic peel. Orange blossom are the flowers of this plant. The other parts of this plant are orange leaves and orange wood. Orange blossom essence is an important component in making of perfume. Orange blossom honey or citrus honey can be obtained by putting beehives into the citrus grooves of the trees while the trees still bloom. Orange leaves can be boiled to make orange tea. Orange wood are used as cuticle pushers in manicures and pedicures and as pugers for manipulating slender electronic wires. Hope this information helped you know more about oranges. Thank you.
Hello everyone. Myself Om Cheri from 7th F is here to discuss about a species of an ornamental medicinal plant, Krishnakamal or passion flower. Passion flower or the maypop plant is a beautiful ornamental plant cultivated for its impressive flowers, edible fruits, and medicinal properties. Its scientific name is Passiflora incarnata and belongs to the family Passiflorae and genus Passiflora. The plant is also known as Krishna Kamal. The reason behind this is the structure of the flower. Some say that it is associated with Mahabharata from the Indian mythology. The plant is native to North, Central and South America, but is being naturalized all over India also. Passiflora incarnata is a herbaceous perennial vine with a strong woody stems. It climbs up with the help of tendrils. The passion flower vine produces very beautiful white flowers with pink, blue or purple calyx crown blooms. The flower is complex, about 10 cm in diameter, with 5 sepals and petals similar in appearance and whitish in color, surmounted by a corona of blue or violet filaments, 5 greenish yellow stamens and 3 purple stigmas. The leaves are alternate, about 10 to 18 cm long and wide. The leaves have 3 lobes. The passion fruit is a smooth yellow oval-shaped berry containing numerous seeds. The color, the fragrance, the shape of the flower, the fruit, the leaves, everything about this plant is simply unique and magically beautiful. A passion flower is used as an herbal supplement historically in treating anxiety, insomnia, seizures, and hysteria. A decoction of passion flower has successfully been used in bronchial asthma. It is used as an anti-asthmatic, anti-diabetic, antidepressant, and anti-inflammatory. Thank you.
Morning, my respected mom and my dear friends. I, Master Aryan Gundwa from 6th F, is going to show you a rare and interesting cactus which I have. Moon cactus is a species of cactus from South America. They are generally kept as house plants. They also have various different names like ruby ball or red cap. They get these names because the flower of the plant completely lacks chlorophyll, thus exposing the red, orange or yellow pigmentation. In wild, these cactuses live up to hundreds of years, but as houseplants, they only live up to 10 years. The best soil for this plant is rich, fast-draining cactus-mixed soil. They also keep the environment around us clean and good. Since they absorb carbon dioxide, they are called the filters of the environment. Thank you.
Our legendary country, India, is not only rich in terms of culture and heritage, but also in terms of flora and fauna. So today, I, Ms. Raghvi Desaya from Grade 70, would like to draw your attention towards the rare but magnificent star species, Heliconia sativa. Due to its beauty, it is treasured by many names like Lady Dinah, Red Dinah, False Bird of Paradise, etc. Due to its insane gorgeousness, it is cultivated as an ornamental plant. The unique species of the plant is that it is capable of pollinating itself. It is a native herb of Caribbean and South America. The plant has both male and female parts. Thank you.
Hello everyone, my name is Aru Shingari from Grade 6A. Do you know about silk cotton? You must be thinking, how can silk be cotton, right? Well, silk cotton is a type of fiber that is as soft as cotton and as smooth as silk. It is used in making fabrics and cotton. Since silk cotton is water resistant, it is also used in making life jackets and pillows. In silk cotton, both the fiber and its seeds are used. Let me explain the process. Silk cotton is formed in a fruit like this. When the fruit ripens, it bursts open, exposing the fiber. It is then plucked and sent into processing by ginning and made into yarn. This yarn is then used for weaving and or knitting. Another name for the kapok tree is a Java tree, and the scientific name is Bombax sepia. It can grow up to 25 meters, which is 82 feet at a medium rate. And this is the Bombax sepia. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Mani Lal and I study in grade 6B. Look what I have with me. Yes, you have guessed it right. It's a lemon fruit. I simply love the tiny taste of the lemon juice made of it. Well, today I am here to share some information on the plant which bears this fruit, the lemon tree. The scientific name of the lemon tree is Citrus linus, and it is a species of the small evergreen tree in the flowering plant family Rutaceae, native to the Indian subcontinent. They grow well in tropical and subtropical regions of the world. Secondly, they can grow up to 4 meters in height, and people usually grow it from seeds. However, we can also propagate it from cuttings or roots of earth. Moreover, the plant is hardy and resilient and grows well in rocky soil.
Most importantly, it can tolerate a wide variety of environmental conditions, which makes it perfect for Indian climates. The tree's yellow fruit is used for culinary and non-culinary purposes throughout the world, primarily for its juice, which has both culinary and cleaning uses. The pulp and rind are also used in cooking and baking. The juice of the lemon is about 5-6% citric acid, giving it a sour taste. Distinctive sour taste of the lemon juice makes it a key ingredient in foods and drinks such as lemonade and lemon topping pie. Lemons are high in vitamin C and can help to prevent common cold. Vitamin C can also help to prevent cardiovascular disease, stroke, and low BP. Vitamin C in lemon can reduce skin wrinkling, dry skin, and damage from the sun. The peel can be used to manufacture of pectin, which is used as a gelling agent and stabilizer in food and other products. The leaves of the lemon tree are used to make a tea and for making cooked meats and seafoods. The lemon oil extracted from the oil-containing cells in the skin can be used for aromatherapy. Thank you.
His scientific name is Erica Catechue, and it belongs to the Ericaceae family. Its order is Ericales, and it belongs to the kingdom of Plantae. Erica tree family is normally found in much of the tropical Pacific, Asia, and some parts of East Africa. It is believed to have origin from Philippines, but it is widespread in cultivation, so it is considered naturalized in some countries such as South China, India, Bangladesh, Taiwan, Sri Lanka, etc. In English, some common names of this plant are betel palm tree, betel nut palm, areca nut palm, Indian nut palm, pinang palm, and catechue. In English, it is called the betel tree because its fruit, the areca nut, is chewed along with the leaf of a vine of the family Piperaceae. The diameter of the tree trunk is 10 to 15 centimeters, and the length of the crowded leaflets are 1.5 to 2 meters, and these trees are mostly 20 meters tall. In India, dry fallen leaves are collected and hot pressed into disposable plates and bowls. Now I'm going to show you the fruit of areca palm.
We all know pineapple, and it's my favorite fruit. A pineapple is a tropical plant which has an edible fruit in the center, and it's the most significant plant in the family of bromeliads. It is used in many ways. Do you know an interesting fact about pineapple? Where it was first cultured? It was first cultured in South America for many centuries. It is used for making pineapple pickles, pineapple juices, and it can be eaten raw. It was first introduced in Europe in 17th century, and it was the most important tropical plant in the world production. Thank you.
everyone. My name is Aniksha Prafushindi from Grade 7B. And today, I'm here to display a new rare species of medicinal plant, which is Acacara. Aniculus pyretum, Indian trade name Acacara, is a small, tiny, herbaceous perennial plant, belongs to Asteraceae family. It is native to Arabia, North Africa, and in India, it is found in the Himalayas and Jammu and Kashmir. The leaves of this plant are pinnate, alternate, and have deeply cut segments. The roots are commonly known as pyretae roots, brown in color and measure from 7 to 15 cm in length, having aromatic odor and pungent taste. The roots have pyrethrine and L-alkylamides in it. Pyrethrine is registered as a botanical product by the United States Environmental Protection Agency, EPA. The flower significant part also possesses insecticidal property. It has anti-diabetic, antioxidant property, treating asthma, cardiac diseases, lung problems, throat issues, and cough and cold. Also, it treats arthritis, stomach aches, headaches, and many more. It also has a unique property which helps in the speech problems in the younger kids. Really, Acacara has a very important value in the market line too. Acacara oil, flowers, fungal infections are sold here. Valuable gift. It is the most valuable gift by the nature to the human being. Thank you.
Hello everyone, my name is Alson Mathew and I study in grade 7J. Today I'm going to tell you some important points on bamboo. Bamboo's scientific name is Bambus indica. And bamboo forests are undoubtedly one of the most abundant non-timber plants on the earth and cover a wide area of tropical and subtropical regions around the world. This amazing plant has a unique rapid growth and can play an important role in protecting our planet from pollution and improving the soil. Bamboo can be used as a biofuel, food, and for agriculture and construction application, and plays a large role in the local economy by creating job opportunities. The aim of this paper is to review the extraordinary tropical plant bamboo by explaining the mechanisms related to the growth and strength of bamboo and identifying ways to utilize bamboo in industry, employment, climate change mitigation, and soil erosion reduction. Bamboo is also the favorite food of pandas, and pandas often eat them. That's why pandas live near where bamboo grows. Thank you.
Everyone, today I joined D'Souza from grade 7. I would like to give you some information about a medicinal plant, balloon vine. Balloon vine, also known as balloon plant or lavender puff, is a climbing plant widely distributed across tropical and subtropical areas of Africa, Australia, and North America. Its scientific name is Cardiospermum halicicabum. The specific epithet halicicabum comes from the Greek word for salt berry and refers to the inflated fruits, after which the common name balloon vine is derived. It is among the 10 sacred plants of Kerala, collectively known as Dasapushpam. Balloon vine is employed for treating stiffness of the limbs, rheumatism, nervous conditions, as well as snake bite. Though the mature leaves are too bitter and hairy to enjoy cooked or raw, the young leaves may be used in recipes. When finely ground in a blender or food processor, however, the taste becomes bitterer than even a bitter gourd. As a bitter green, the taste of balloon vine makes it too strong to use as the only ingredient, such as making it the base of a salad or green stir fry. Rather, it accentuates existing batters and soups. Thank you.
Petunia. These are colorful flowers mostly native to South America. These are annual in cold climates. They are used for making flower beds. They are non-toxic and some genus has been traditionally claimed to be used for treatment of asthma, flu, bronchitis, high blood pressure, eczema, and diabetes. Aster. They are also called as froth flowers. They come mostly in white, purple, blue, pink or red in color. They are perennial plants. They are mostly found in North America. They grow in full sun. Aster roots are used in soups and these can be topically used to aid with headaches. Thank you.
Mammillaria mathilda is a plant species in the family Cacticae. It is endemic to Querétaro, Mexico. Its natural habitat is hot deserts. It is of IUCN Red List vulnerable status and threatened by habitat loss. There are hardly 500 of these cactus left.
Good morning, friends. I am Durva Pala from grade 16. Today, as you can see, I am standing in this lush green area of jungle at my native place in Malvan, Sindhudurga, that is in Konkan region. Today, I am going to narrate you many aspects of this beautiful Konkan tree. This tree belongs to mangosteen family, that is Clusiaceae, and its scientific name is Garcinia indica. This tree locally has many names, but in this region, that is in Konkan region, it is known as Ratamba. This tree is mainly found in tropical zones or regions, like in some parts of Asia and Africa. In India, it is found in Konkan, Maharashtra, Goa, and in some parts of Karnataka. Over 200 species of this tree are known. The leaves are shiny, bright green, and elongated in shape. This tree can grow in hot and humid climate. This absolutely amazing tree can grow without irrigation, fertilizers, and pesticides. As you can see, this evergreen tree can grow as high as 18 meters. Let's come to its fruit. The tree blossoms in the month of February and the fruits ripe in summer, that is in the month of April and May. The fruit is like a shape of an orange, red or purple in color with fleshy pulp. It is full of vitamin C. The pulp is collected in this wooden boat-like structure called dona in local language. This collected pulp is known as agur. Agur is used to make a relishing drink called solkadi, which is made by adding coconut milk to agur. Agur also has medicinal use. It is used for skin allergies and rashes when applied on the skin. Now, the remaining outer cover, that is the peel of kokum fruit, is sun-dried after dipping 3 times in agur to make kokum or amsul in local language. Fresh fruit is preserved with sugar to make a bright red squash. The squash is diluted in water to make the best thirst-satisfying drink called kokum sarbat. It's delicious. It is helpful to lower the acidity in stomach ulcers. Best part of this tree is kokum butter. Do you all know how it is derived? It is derived from the seeds of kokum fruit. The kernel inside the seed contains 44 to 46% of oil, which remains solid in room temperature. Kokum butter is used to prepare several chocolate and sugar confectionaries like sweets. Kokum butter is also used to cook and fry several Malvani Marathi dishes like ragi puris and vadis. It contains stearic and oleic acid, which is good for our hair and skin. It is used in several ointments for cracked heels, dry lips, and skin. Now, you must have understood that this tree is very important for us because it gives us so many things which are useful for our daily lives.